Hello, my name is Ulrike Protzer. I'm a director of the Institute of Virology at the Technical University of Munich and at Helmholtz, Munich in Germany. And being trained as a hepatologist and as a clinical virologist, I would like to discuss with you today what we need to achieve an HBV cure. Is that antiviral therapy? Is that immune therapy? Or do we maybe need both? Let's first have a look at what is available as therapies. The most well-known therapeutics are NUCs, so-called NUCs, nucleoside analogs, which you may know as entecavir or tenofovir. They block the formation of infectious viral capsids and infectious viruses. So your DNA and the serum gets negative if you take those drugs. Newer developments include capsid assembly modulators. They also prevent the formation of new infectious capsids. However, none of them affects the persistence form of the virus, which is a so-called cccDNA deposited in the nucleus of infected cells. We also have interferons available, which can cure HBV in a low percentage, but have relatively high side effects, and that's therefore people don't like them. And a little similar, newer developments include TLR agonists and siRNAs. All of them affect also the RNA of the virus and the release of viral antigens, like, for example, the HBs antigen. And last but not least, there is entry blockers under development. And entry blockers block the infection of new cells, so they prevent that more cells get infected. However, they do not cure cells which already have been infected. And in those cells, the cccDNA persists. That means none of these antivirals can really cure HBV. The antiviral drugs suppress HBV, and they are useful to stabilize your liver disease, but on their own, they do not cure HBV. So how can a chronic hepatitis B then be cured? You could think about killing infected hepatocytes in the liver. You could also think about diluting the cccDNA by cell division and thus over time getting rid of the virus. And there is immune mediators, so-called cytokines, which can induce the degradation of the cccDNA in the nucleus. And all these can be done by an immune therapy which activates T cells, making that a very interesting approach. Now, looking at the immune control that determines the course of hepatitis B helps you to think of which would be a good immune therapy to use. And in the case of a chronic hepatitis B, you have something which is called an immune tolerance, which basically means it's a sleeping immune system. In this case, T cells are really scarce. They are hard to identify at all, and there is no neutralizing antibodies. However, in a case where the virus is controlled and finally cured, so in a self-limiting infection, there you have strong helper and effector T cell responses and also strong antibody responses. So the immune system is very, very alert, and there is immune control. Now, the question is, how can we get the immune tolerance state, so the sleeping immune system, to a state where it's alert and controls the virus? So what could be the wake-up call? And that could theoretically be a therapeutic vaccine, which is a very promising candidate here. So an ideal immune therapy would induce an orchestrated adaptive immune response. That means the CD4 helper T cells are induced that help the B cells. The B cells then produce antibodies, and the antibodies capture the virus and prevent the spread of the virus and the infection of new cells. The CD4 T cells also help the CD8 T cells, which are the effector T cells that finally eliminate HBV-infected hepatocytes and thus achieve a cure. And this type of an orchestrated immune response can be achieved by a therapeutic vaccine if it is well designed. So our conclusion here would be an antiviral therapy is important as long as no curative therapy exists, but a therapy with the available nukes does not cure HPV infection. New antivirals are on their way, but their potential to cure HPV is unclear so far. And a therapeutic vaccine, being an immune therapy, can reactivate the immune response and has the potential to cure HPV. However, at the end, those therapeutic vaccines or also other immune therapies may need to be combined with antiviral therapies in order to allow for reactivating HPV-directed immunity and finally cure HPV. So thank you very much for listening. And if you want to learn more about HPV cure, then check the ICE-HBV FAQ page.